As you might have guessed, graph partitioning is NP-complete. So your first intuition about graphs is that you need to look for good heuristics and try to exploit special structure wherever possible. Here's a first simple heuristic. It's called graph bisection, and it's based on the principle of divide and conquer. The idea is simple. Suppose you want P partitions. Start by first using any algorithm to divide the graph into two partitions. Then divide each half into two. You would repeat this process until you obtain the desired number of partitions. That's nice, but not very satisfying. After all, how do you get two-way partitions? We'll get there, but first, let's build some more intuition. Now, some graphs are special. For instance, this graph is planar. A planar graph is one that can be drawn in the plane with no edge crossings. So for instance, here's another planar graph. By the way, this thing is supposed to be a tapir. For planar graphs, there's a really neat theorem. This theorem is, in fact, due in part to Georgia Tech's very own Dick Lipton. Anyway, the theorem goes like this. Given a graph with n vertices, the theorem says that there's a way to partition the vertices into three disjoint sets, A, B, and S, such that the following super cool properties hold. The first one is that S is a separator for V. That is, there are no edges that directly connect A and B. Put differently, the subset of vertices S acts as a kind of wall between A and B. In other words, if you take the separator out of a connected graph, you get two or more connected subgraphs. That's the first property. Here's the second. Each of the subsets, A and B, have no more than 2/3 n vertices each. That's really neat, too. Because if one of the partitions has at most 2/3 n vertices, then the other has at least 1/3. That in turn means that the larger of the two partitions is no more than twice the size of the other. If the two partitions are within a factor of two of each other, then that's pretty balanced. Well, sort of. Maybe if you crane your neck a lot and look at a funny angle. Well, a factor of two is good enough for government work, dagnabbit. The third property is the neatest. It says that the size of the vertex separator is about square root of n. For the grid or lattice graph, this result should make intuitive sense. A natural separator for this grid graph would be, say, some row or some column of vertices. Such a row or column would, of course, be root n in size. Now, the existence of a planar separator does not guarantee you can minimize the edge cut efficiently. But keeping this lattice graph in mind, an algorithm that can find this separator should, heuristically, find a decent partition. In fact, Lipton and Targin in their original paper described a polynomial time algorithm to find such a separator. Anyway, there's a ton of cool work related to more general separator theorems. Head to the instructor's notes for some pointers.